role was changed this year by the implementation of Kevin Durant. Back in 3 minutes. Don't go away.
This is funny.
She got an attitude. I like the way she moves with them baby fat shoes. I wanna see her with the lights on. It's dark in the club, plus the music too loud. I wanna know your damn name, not your damn drink. I'm a G gentleman, I got range. She a little peach dancer and she go to Clark Atlanta. I make it, she be trapping on the block in your hood. Either way, she bad, she got class. Everybody drop their drinks when she bad. She work a job, but she hustle inside. Anything trying to kill her, she can buy. I want her on my team, she my point guard. I love her cause she's soft and hard. Poetry. She poetry. She poetry. She poetry.
I love her cause she's poetry. She poetry. She poetry. She poetry.
She's sweet, her swag is divine. If you ain't got a hustle, man, you're wasting her time. So don't you even walk up to her table. She doesn't need the hassle, so she can buy her own drink. She been bad, she's a 10 on the lady scale. Don't get me wrong, sometimes she raise hell. I bet I like it though, she's so ghetto. Or maybe she too busy for your cats in the city. She already done met all your people or not. I haven't even said hello. She's got to be the most beautiful sex and she's hot. Her poetry got to be it, she just got. I love the way she words her phrases, she amazing. I just want to know her inside. I ain't kicking, I'm just keeping it real. I'm picking, or maybe I'm just using my head.
She poetry. She poetry.
They got that little damn, that damn kazoo sound in the background. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show, 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. My man Jeff Fox coming on immediately following me today at 1 p.m. Eastern Time right here on WSME. Make sure you are locked in. Falcons owner Arthur Blank honored both Michael Vick and Roddy White in a ceremony Monday and said the team will consider retiring their jerseys. Consider? Come on, man. What do you mean consider? Come on, man. Quote, we have a process that we'll have to go through with that. And certainly given their records as Falcons players and their careers, they would certainly be considered for that, Arthur Blank said in talking about retiring these cast jerseys. According to the team, six players have had their jerseys retired. Number 10, Steve Barkowski. Number 31, William Andrews. Number 57, Jeff Van Note. Number 58, Jesse Tuggle. Number 60, Tommy Nobis. And number 78, Mike Kinn. All six are on the team's nine-member ring of honor. Here's a quote. Yes, I care if I get my jersey hanging up there, White told ESPN. Yes, I do want that. At this point, I'm the franchise's all-time leading receiver, and I probably played one of the longest tenures as a Falcon. I've been pretty successful. Deep down in my heart, I would love that. I want it all. Yes, I want my jersey retired. The ring of honor, I think that goes along with it. Roddy ain't bashful. Roddy White ain't bashful at telling you how he feels. As far as the Falcons and his position in the legacy of the organization, Roddy White was introduced by former teammate and fellow receiver Brian Finneran, who broke into tears while describing what White meant to the franchise. He says, let's see. I'm not one, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. I wanted to read one more quote from you, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. I'm not the one who makes the decision, but both of these guys deserve to be hanging in those rafters, Von McClure said, former Falcon. If I were to ask you with this franchise, why do you think of, or who do you think of, and what do you think about this guy right here, Michael Vick, you think about Roddy White. Those are the guys that impacted the city and impacted the organization, and I think they should be hanging in the rafters, said Todd McClure, who introduced Vick on Monday. He referred to Vick as the king of Atlanta and said Vick changed the culture. Y'all have heard me say this before, but for anybody new to the show, when Mike Vick played for the Falcons, it was a freaking carnival every Sunday. It was like Freaknik downtown at the Georgia Dome, okay? The whole atmosphere, the whole vibe, and, you know, BV before Vick, and when Vick got here, it was just totally different. You know, even now, I mean, it's great. It's still great to go down and watch the Falcons play. The team obviously has been doing a bunch of great things, but the tailgate atmosphere, the culture around Sundays isn't what it was when MV7 was here. That's just a fact. And as I said yesterday, a lot of people will never forgive the guy for the whole dogfighting thing, and that's fine. I'm not going to even debate that anymore. If you still mad at this guy after he went to jail for 2 years, paid restitution, has apologized 11 times, literally 11 times, I think that's a you problem. I think at this point, that's a you thing that you're going to have to deal with. You're going to have to look yourself in the mirror and be like, damn. I mean, at what point do you forgive somebody? At what point do you move on? I hate to even get into that conversation, but I think that you have to retire Vic's jersey. You did this ceremony on yesterday. I think you have to retire Vic's jersey. You have to retire Roddy White's jersey, who surpassed in receiving yards. Once again, Terrence Mathis and Andre Rison and all of those guys. I think you got to do it. And Vic and Roddy kind of tied to the hip. And during the whole dogfighting thing, Roddy was one of his adamant supporters, you know. And so we'll see. I think they're going to have to do that, though. Nobody else can wear number 7. Now, I think they're going to do Roddy. I think Roddy's jersey will get retired, too. But, like, how you look putting on number 7 in ATL? Yeah, and I don't think anybody's had it since Vic's gone. Has anybody worn number 7? Maybe I'm wrong about that. Maybe a backup quarterback or, you know, a punter or a kicker has worn number 7. I just don't remember right now. But you're going to look real odd wearing number 7 playing for the Atlanta Falcons for the rest of eternity. So we'll see we'll see what's up with that. But I think that was a good move by the Falcons. A lot of people, once again, didn't like it, but I know a lot of people did like it and think that it was appropriate. From Al the Bandit, Mark Jackson winds this talent as well. Hell, Mark Massey could coach this team. That's true. From Rough Buff, this dude does not know what he's talking about. Talking about Brandon Peters, you have a different opinion. I wouldn't say he doesn't know what he's talking about. This is what he does. I mean, he kind of follows the Golden State Warriors. He writes for basketball magazines. He's from Oakland. I don't think that you can say you probably know more about the Golden State Warriors than he does. I don't think so. From Woody 504, Mark Jackson was basically coaching when he still was playing on the Pacers. Mark Jackson ran all the sideline timeouts. What is this ninja talking about? Now, I disagree with him, as I just gave him credit for having knowledge about the Golden State Warriors. I disagree to a large degree about how much credit he gives Mark Jackson for this team and where this team ultimately ended up with winning a couple of championships. Right. I disagree with that. That's my folk and everything, but I disagree with that. But he does follow the team more intimately than even I do, or most people do, as he mentioned. But I disagree with him on his Mark Jackson commentary. From Sidney Jackson and Grego, when folks talk foolishness that goes against actual facts, then they just people aren't willing to listen. From Sidney Jackson, he said OKC has talent. A person with a set of eyes can look at that roster and see that's a damn lie. Once again, that is a second thing that I disagree with him on. Right. That's my man, Hunter Grant. But two things I vehemently disagree with him on, and I said it when we did the interview. I disagree with him on the effect and the – and the credit Mark Jackson deserves for that organization being where it is today. And I definitely disagree with him in saying that OKC has players on that team. Victor Oladipo, Andre Robertson, who's the guy's name, bushy hair guy? Steven Adams? No. No, no, no. And they didn't have much more than that last year when KD was there. But yet, they were up 3-1. I got to keep mentioning that. They were up 3-1 with pretty much Durant and Westbrook. Pretty much the same team. All right? Yeah. They didn't have Oladipo. So it was Andre Robertson. It was guys like that. And they were up 3-1 on this Golden State team that looked so dominant this year. So, yeah, I disagree with him on that, too. Sidney Jackson Duncan, I remember hearing about it from Mark Jackson. He said Clay and Steph were the best shooting backcourt in NBA history, and folks said he was crazy. Now everyone is on the same opinion. Very true. We've talked about that many times before. Mark Jackson, when he said that a couple of years ago, I was like, really, dude? Really? You know how long they've been playing in the NBA? How long NBA basketball has been along? And you saying these young cats with milk around their mouth are, you know, the best shooting backcourt in NBA history? He was right. There's not much debate. He was right. And that was before they got KD. That was Klay and Steph. And he was right then. He was right last year about the team and about the year before. About those two guys being the best shooting backcourt of all time. I pretty much agree. And who are we to question Mark Jackson? When he said it, we should have thought about that fact at the time. It is Mark Jackson. He kind of knows what he's talking about when you're talking about basketball. But we poo-pooed on him. Man, this ninja crazy. Come to find out, he was probably right. Back in 3 minutes, the Doug Stewart Show, hour number 3.
So you stayed on the move, giving all my time to the other life. You grabbed a girl and you made her your wife. But that puzzles me, cause I always been the queen that you said you always wanted to meet. So now I'm all alone because of the life you chose. Left me in pain, and I want you to know that I
know it's gonna feel like that.
Everything that you've done to me will come back. Can't believe that you hurt me that bad.
I know it's gonna feel like that.
Everything that you've done to me will come back. Can't believe that you hurt me that bad. You lost my love, and you lost my. You played me like a fool, cause I was lost in lust. How you broke my heart, I knew from the start you were out to break my heart. But now I'm over it, cause karma is a bitch, and when it comes around, it comes around, time's ten. So no more lonely.
Come back.